Good day.
Good day.
Sorry?
Good day.
Good day. Welcome back to the
Good Day podcast.
See, we've nailed that now.
Absolutely brilliant. Three times?
Nine episodes, three times. Yeah, we three proper tries.
So I actually started co-hosting, not just sitting here.
Yeah, well, after Jacob dissed you and said...
Did he diss me?
Yeah, he said, it's good job Charlie was on that podcast. And I was like, what do you mean? He was like, oh, you just didn't input anything.
Where?
I can't remember which episode. It was the one before him, I think.
The one with Aoife?
Yeah.
If anything, I did input the most on that one. He's chatting shit.
Chatting it.
You weigh 98 kilos. Shush.
And it's took us 3 seconds to already diss our mates.
Don't care.
It's a nut. It's a normal episode,
as always.
We can
blur that one out because we want to get brand deals. So please give us money. Please.
Yes. So who do you want to get sponsored by? Who would you want? Here's a question then. Your first ideal sponsorship. In an ideal world, you could have any of them.
Durex.
Really? That would be the worst one to have.
No. Archers of Bewdley.
Archers? I want to start a football team up now, just have Archers on the top.
No, they actually would sponsor
you. They would
you,
probably sponsor
Al would, yeah.
Jack.
He would, yeah.
I reckon we start that up, you know. I was looking today how much it costs.
To start up a Sunday league team?
It's £1,000 for the football kits if you're not sponsored. Like for
not
home
sponsored.
And away, yeah.
But like if you are sponsored, they just pay for it.
I think they cover it.
Oh, Al would do that.
Go on, Al.
I'll have a word of him.
Yeah, Al, if you're watching this.
He definitely isn't.
If you're not watching this, please still sponsor us.
Please. He loves me though, so it's fine.
Huh?
He loves me, so it's
fine. Well, there you go. We'll get that going. Hopefully we get 11 aside up.
Mm. More content.
More content. Get some side content going, you know.
Yeah. Not just the shitty podcast. Actually good content.
Come on, we're coming up to episode 10
now. True. We're nearly beating the rest of the worst.
Yes, top 1% or 5%?
We're nearly top 5%.
Of all podcasters. So
look at us go, man.
Who to us?
This is where we both like die in a fatal car accident and never actually get to episode 10. So we are the average.
Okay, yeah. That's why actually 95% don't succeed.
Yeah, they all die. It's like the Illuminati of podcasts. They just kill them off before they get a chance. Yeah.
God, we're trying so much.
I know, man. This is horrible. Sorry. Should we actually get on with the episode?
Yeah, let's actually get on with the episode. We haven't got much changes since last week. Obviously, the topics...
I'm less fucked.
Yes, Charlie's is less
I've
fucked.
Healed, sort of.
I've noticed
not,
that.
Not mentally, but physically I have.
It took you about a week and a half, I would say.
To mentally heal?
Mentally heal.
I'm still not mentally healed.
No, you are scarred. And I have said that to quite a lot of people. It's changed you. I can see you're more snappier with people. And
yeah.
You just haven't got time like you did have before.
Time
for people.
Oh, it hasn't.
It's just changed it completely.
Busy man.
And that is what a horrendous night will do to you, I suppose. It takes a toll on your soul.
It really does, yeah. It's not fun. Oh, in fact, like, I watched back a few of the clips of the last episode. Oh, I'm so sorry.
What?
Fucking hell. I just look so unimpressed all the time. I'm just in a shit mood. In a terrible mood. It's just horrendous.
That's when I showed you the, before we started actually filming the pod. The difference between me and you. Like, I come on, I was all like this, and Charlie was just like...
Just depressed.
Just depressed, but...
It's no. Okay not to be okay.
It is okay not to... Is that Jessie J? It's okay
no,
not
it's...
to be okay.
Is it?
I think she's got a song.
Sure, man.
That will be... Oh, no, it won't be later money, on. We're doing money, movies. Money. Yes, let's actually get into it now.
Okay.
This is probably going to be the shortest episode we're going to do. Because we've got some bangers coming out.
Oh, yes.
In the following weeks.
Yes.
We won't spoil
Although prepare it. For the next one. That's going to be a lengthy one of just pure shit.
Yes. So. First, the next episode, spoiler alert, is going to be our first sort of drunk podcast.
Oh, God.
With a very special guest of ours. One of the weirdest people we know. But
he's very special.
Funniest people we know as well. Coming all the way from Solihull.
Yeah.
So that
big trek.
Hockley Heath to be precise.
To be precise.
Episode 10, so we thought we'd go out.
Yeah. And after that,
Another banger.
And then after that, a potential of a banger.
Yes, yes. So
I hope Palmer still looks American though for his episode. He can't cut his hair.
He does.
He does look American though.
He looks very American. I thought he dyed it. He said he hasn't. But that's just what happens when you go to America.
Yeah,
too long.
You
become American.
Sadly.
Hey guys.
Hey man.
Okay.
Right. Moving on.
Topic one. Usyk Dubois. It is a sort of a hot topic, I suppose.
Yeah, sort of. Well, I feel like it's sort of, it was for a day.
Yeah.
And then I haven't heard anything since.
Have you not? No, I've still seen quite a few TikToks on it. So, people complaining about the low blow and whatnot. Obviously, there was some controversy in round five, I believe.
I think so.
It's when Dubois dropped Usyk with a
legal blow.
Illegal.
I think it was.
Okay, Charlie's made his statement already, thinks it's illegal, but the ref called it as an illegal blow, a low blow, shall we say, because it was below the belt. Yeah. So obviously when it's a low blow or an illegal shot, the person it's on has 5 minutes to recover. The ref actually gave him
4 minutes.
Well, 4 minutes in total. But Usyk was ready after this third minute, but the ref encouraged him to have another minute.
Mm.
So people are saying, not match fixing, but people are saying the ref is definitely on Usyk's side and whatnot.
Yeah, it did seem that way in the fight though, to be fair.
Yeah, so he was given almost 4 minutes. Daniel Dubois also, some stuff happened after the fight. Tony Bellew accused him of quitting again, said it
I hate him so much.
What, Tony Bellew?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know. He just chats shit, doesn't he?
No, I quite like him, to be fair.
He's a scouse as well.
I think he's class. I think he's a shithouse. So then, obviously, Daniel Dubois retaliated and just called him a hater, pretty much. So the three...
You hater, man.
You're such a hater, man. The three questions following this, then. So in your opinion, was it below the belt? Was it a legal shot?
I think it was legal.
You think it was legal?
Yeah.
And why would you... Why would one say it was illegal?
Well, I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, I watched it back and it was actually above the belt.
Above the belt?
I think it was.
Yeah.
And even so, like, it wouldn't have been that low.
No, it definitely wasn't a... It didn't hit any genitals.
No, that's what I mean. Been like his liver.
Liver. But I suppose if that is... Because it did hit below his shorts, didn't it?
Mm.
Whether he was wearing his shorts too high, because he was wearing his shorts just under his belly button, wasn't he?
Yeah, they were quite high.
They were quite high, so it's whether you consider that is illegal or whatnot. But
yeah.
I watched someone do a frame by frame, which is quite sad, but someone was doing by frame with lines and everything, and he put it as a legal shot because of what you said, and also they wear cups, don't they? And no, the cup didn't shake once. You would see it through the...
Yeah, yeah. I just think he was helped quite a bit in the fight anyway, because even like when he had a knockdown, it looked to me like Dubois slipped.
Yeah.
He slipped and then Usyk sort of walked into him and sort of pushed him over with his legs rather than actually landing a clean shot and taking him down. Yeah. To me, it looked like he sort of slipped and then Usyk sort of walked into him and forced him to fall over.
Yeah. It's annoying, really, because I wanted it to be... like a clean and clear W for Usyk, just so that the fight with Fury would then look so much better.
Mm.
But now there's going to be some stuff behind this fight now. Like if Dubois wants a rematch, then Usyk's going to have to honour that pretty much.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, true.
Because of all the stuff that's gone on now.
I still think he would have been...
I think Usyk would have won regardless.
But he fucked him up after, didn't he?
He did fuck him up. And... people might say, oh, because he had all that time to recover, he could have been screwed if he didn't have that time. But I think he would have...
Dubois had the same time.
Yeah.
To sort of rest, if anything.
Yeah, yeah.
So he should have been in better shape, if anything.
Yeah, so...
He still lost, so...
Was Dubois robbed, would you say?
I think he was robbed, yeah.
Robbed of the fight?
I do think he was, but regardless of the fact, like, he still fucked him up after, so...
Yeah.
There's not really much he could have done. I mean, yeah, I do think... I don't know. I think it was a legal blow.
So he wasn't... he was robbed and it was a legal blow in your eyes, yeah?
Easy.
Perfect.
What about you, Maximus?
I think it was a legal shot.
Mm.
But I don't think he was robbed. It's very much this whole VAR thing. Do you know what I mean?
What do you mean?
I don't like the whole after examination and analysis.
I think, yeah, I do.
Because in the moment, if there wasn't 500 instant replays in slow motion, I think people wouldn't even question the referee's decision, because it did look like a low blow, and I think people would have just been fine with that. And you've got to take into account the atmosphere, the crowd, everything, and yeah. In that case, I don't think he was robbed. I think it was just the fact that everyone's overanalyzed it and
yeah,
whatnot.
I do think that ruined sport. In sport, you need like the sort of controversial moments, don't you? So
yeah, just leave it in the present moment. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I hate it.
There's going to be all this. I think they tried to what's the word after contest it. I think
appeal.
Daniel Dubois tried to contest that it was a legal shot, and that should therefore count as not a win on Usyk's side. But it's just like,
yeah,
you wouldn't have contested that realistically if you didn't have all those replays.
Yeah, you wouldn't have at all.
You would have. Everyone would have just allowed it. So
yeah,
it's a bit annoying, but yeah.
Oh well.
Did he quit then? Do you agree with Tony? Your mate, Tony?
I don't think he quit. I just think he got a bit disheartened.
Yeah,
and like just sort of like, fuck's sake.
Yeah,
sort of thing. So I don't know.
I think the more rounds, the less chance he had of winning.
Definitely.
100%. I think his best shot was in the first five rounds. So like you said, he probably got a bit disheartened when he technically knocked him down.
Yeah.
Could have won it. And then it carried on going to the distance.
Yeah.
Well, not to the distance. It stopped in round nine. But yeah, it was a decent fight, I suppose.
It was a shit fight.
You think
it was a shit fight. Nothing happened, man. Nothing happened.
No.
I don't know if that was just because... I don't even know. It was just shit. Was not a good fight at all.
It wasn't as good as I thought. I thought Usyk was going to put on a masterpiece, to be fair.
I feel like I haven't seen a good fight in ages, though.
Well, I do want to see Usyk Fury, though, still.
I don't think Fury will come out of retirement, though.
He'll come out of retirement for any dollar sign, I think.
Well, I've started watching that At Home of the Furies now.
Oh, is that any good?
Yeah, it's decent, to be fair. I'm on like episode 2 or 3.
I was going to watch it.
But yeah, from what it sounds like, I don't know. It just seems like... It seems like he wants to come out, like come back into boxing, but he just doesn't know. Well, his wife doesn't want him to do it, understandably.
Paris.
Yeah, but it's more the fact that he wants to be like a father to his children now. So
He's got... Six kids, hasn't
six
he?
Kids, yeah. They're
almost
all look
seven.
Like little shits as well.
Yeah. They are funny though.
They are funny, but they all look like rough as fuck and like little shits, yeah.
Yeah. Have you seen that video when Paris and Tyson are working out?
No.
And the kids come in and then Tyson goes, "Go on then, get off now." And the one says, "Fuck off."
I saw one and Tyson's reading them like a bedtime story.
Yeah.
And he was telling them like something about like, I don't know, like the three, is it? The something to do with the wolf blowing a house over.
Oh, yeah.
But it was about Tyson blowing a caravan over. And then he finished it and the little kid goes, "That's shit."
they've probably been taught to swear from a very young age. But
yeah, definitely. But yeah, it's all right.
I quite like the whole gypsy lifestyle though.
Of course you do.
Sure. No, I think it's a free way of living. Do you know what I mean?
It is, yeah. But I think once you've lived in a house, you couldn't do it.
I don't know. It depends location.
Yeah, but could you
well.
Go without your phone, all that stuff?
Probably.
But you couldn't.
If I had a beautiful gal by my side.
Well, you don't want a relationship, so.
That is also true. Well, unless one comes along, you know. I'm not opposed to it. I'm just not looking for it.
Bollocks.
How's that bollocks? People don't understand that.
It's bollocks.
I said that once. I was like, "Oh, I'm not looking for a relationship." And a girl was like, "Oh, that's such a red flag." I was like, "Well,
it is a bit of a red flag.
I'm not looking, actively looking, but like, stop it. If it occurs, if it feels right, then I'll do it." Is that not?
That's it. No.
Okay. I think everyone should date like that. Not date like you're trying to get married, but sure. Yeah, I do rate the Gypsies. They're sound, unless you get on the wrong side, then they're not sound. Wrong side again. Moving swiftly on. India. Congratulations.
And celebrations.
Woo-hoo! They have become the first country ever to land a spacecraft on the moon's south pole.
Yeah, boy.
After being laughed at in 2019 for crashing two spacecrafts.
We need Liam on the podcast for this.
Why?
He's half Indian.
Oh, yeah. And he likes the moon.
He does like the moon.
They're now looking to set up a
That's gonna come out.
No. They're now looking to set up a permanent lunar base on the moon for scientists. They've discovered the South Pole craters contain ice.
Wow.
Which can therefore be melted and used for fuel, oxygen, and a water source. So, will we look to start a new lunar civilization, do you think, Charles?
Probably.
What would be the advantages for that?
Like less crowding.
Sort the overpopulation thing out.
Or people can just stop having sex.
I'd rather move to the moon.
Yeah, to be fair. what was the saying?
Also, in billions of years of time, when the sun, when we eventually have to evacuate. Oh, no, because the moon's not that far away.
It's literally not that far away. And it orbits us, so
maybe not. Fucked.
But yeah, I mean,
I suppose it's another step in the right direction, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely, but I do think they're focusing on the moon a bit too much.
You think?
I do find it weird that we just landed on the moon like and then 50 years ago and was like, oh, done it now.
Well, that's what everyone said because of how expensive it was and we did it.
For what it is, it's quite expensive. Yeah. But I'd rather go Mars.
You'd rather go Mars? I think there's better stuff to do on Mars, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, man. 100%. Big quality.
We should start a Mars base.
I just want to go there and just kick the rover. Just kick it.
Is it still up there?
I think so.
Is it?
There's like new ones that keep going because they will just keep dying.
Can you imagine if they saw that on your screen?
Just a random bloke just walks up and just boots it.
That'd be good.
Have it.
So that's quite cool, I think.
It is quite cool.
It would be cool to see a lunar civilization. It won't be in our lifetime. But
I think it might.
What, a whole civilization? Not a civilization.
Well, yeah, but like people moving there. Maybe like a base. People moving there, I think.
Yeah. What do you think?
I think so.
What, in the next, 50, 60 years?
Yeah.
Fair enough. Because they weren't about doing trips to trips to Mars, weren't they?
Yeah, but that's going to take fucking ages, so.
Yeah.
I think, is it Richard Branson that's doing that?
I'm not sure.
Or is he just doing trips to space? Spend like, oh, yeah, if it's loads of money, then no, but I would go. If I had the money to.
You'd go to Mars?
Yeah.
And you can never come back?
Yeah.
What? So you'd go with a group of random people to a whole different planet?
It'd be quality, imagine doing that.
How would that be quality? It just would. It'd be bored out of your mind.
It'd be so funny. Have like a random group of people on Mars just chatting shit
Can you imagine me, you, Jake, to Mars? Oh,
God. That'd be horrendous. We'd own the first pub on Mars, though.
They'd kick us out the ship.
No, would you?
They'd say, nah,
We'd play up on the ship and they'd just be like, nah, fuck off.
I'd go if they'd let us take alcohol.
You're such an alcoholic.
That did sound like an alcoholic.
You're
statement.
Such an alcoholic.
But can you imagine that class up B, alcohol in space?
Drunk in space.
Drunk in space. You'd be like, oh.
Fuck yeah.
What's going on?
It'd be outrageous.
It would be outrageous. What else do you think we'll discover from this moon encounter we've done?
Oh, aliens.
We've already discovered aliens.
Oh, true. Cheese.
Cheese. Do you reckon the robot will start nibbling it?
What?
The moon's made out of cheese, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. What kind of cheese, though? That's some age shit as well.
Probably brie.
Brie? Like brie.
Bog standard cheddar cheese if it was made out of cheese.
No, I think it'd be something grim like Stilton or something.
Oh, you think?
Yeah.
No, because we'd smell it from here. From my
true, earth, actually, yeah.
If it was made out of cheese.
I reckon it'd just be cheddar then, yeah. I think you're right there.
Maybe a baby bell. Is that cheddar?
I don't think it's cheese, to be honest with you, mate.
Is it not cheese?
It's plastic.
It might as well be plastic.
It might as
Did
well.
Did you ever used to eat the plastic from baby bells? You know the red plastic that surrounds it? The casing? Didn't you used to try and eat that?
No.
It did look edible, though.
No, it didn't. It looked like wax.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Would you eat candles now? What? Walking the Yankee candle store.
It had like a weird taste. But and it would get stuck in your teeth.
Yeah, can imagine.
It wasn't the nicest to eat.
You are a strange one, aren't you, Max?
I used to think I was cool eating paper in primary school.
God's sake. I forgot we had this hot scandal in like year three.
Oh, not year three.
Yeah, I know. Where these people were eating paper and they got caught.
I thought, what was up that everyone in primary school just started nomming A4 paper for no reason?
It was lined as well.
Oh, lined paper. Oh, no, I'd never go near the lined stuff. No. It's got to be pure plain.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because lined is like chemicals.
Yeah, like what's that blue ink. Shit and the red shit? Oh, yeah, don't that.
Not even that.
No, no. But yeah.
I just want that plain. So, you know me, I'm quite a plain Jane anyway, aren't I?
You are, actually.
I used to
you
say...
You don't live much, do you?
No. I used to say to the girls, watch this. And then just tear A4 paper and start...
It's better than flicking the bean, though, so...
I flick the bean whenever I want, mate. Have we told that? No, we have told that story, haven't we?
Yeah.
Nobody wants to hear that story again anyway. The real question I wanted to ask you is, when's GTA 6 coming out?
Is that on the sheet?
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah, because the TikTok I saw on this Indian moon landing is everyone's put
I saw that.
Aliens and moon landing before GTA 6. Yeah. When's it coming out?
Never.
Wow.
Wow.
No, October 26th, 2027.
Is it 2027? No, I reckon this year. 2023?
You reckon GTA 6 is coming out in 2023?
It's coming out this year.
Do you think we would know by now?
Do you think we'll be able to fit one more big thing in? Like we've had aliens, we've had this now, the moon. India's on the moon.
Well, I don't think GTA 6 is the level of them, but... Oh, I don't know, actually.
No, it is.
Yeah, it is.
I'd rather have GTA 6 over aliens.
Oh, well, I would as well. Fuck aliens.
Unless they can hear us, then.
GTA 6, or GTA 5 was quality.
So can you imagine what GTA 6 is like? Plus, with like the technology and stuff coming out now, like, you know those... What is it? That Apple thing?
Hmm?
Have you seen it? The Apple VR thing?
Oh, the glasses, yeah.
Yeah, that's crazy, that is.
I really want a pair.
They're about like $3,000 now, aren't they?
Yeah, but it'd be like Jarvis, you know, the glasses. Just, not Spider-Man, Iron Man.
Iron Man. I'd want one just for the plane. I saw someone say, can you imagine watching a film with those on?
It'd be quite cool.
That's the only reason I want. I might spend $3,000 just to watch that on the plane.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Sure, man.
Great stuff.
Great chat.
GTA 6 is next. No, I think there's going to be... I think there's going to be like a natural disaster before GTA 6. That's my theory. Like either a volcano eruption, earthquake, or
I would love to experience hurricane. One of them.
You'd love to experience one of them. Which one? Here's a question then. Would you rather face a hurricane not tornado, what they called, from the sea. What they called. The massive waves.
Tsunami.
Tsunami, thank you.
Begins with what?
Huh?
What
tsunami.
I thought you said it begins with sea.
What?
Okay,
no,
that's fine.
A hurricane, a tsunami, or an earthquake. All two extremes.
Am I going to die or not?
No, it's whatever you think you've got your best chance of survival.
Oh, best chance... probably an earthquake.
No,
I want to experience.
No, because that were the ones where they literally open. There's a crack in the earth.
Yeah.
You think you'd survive that?
Just move to the left.
No, you're in the middle of all of these. So you're in the middle of a middle of a hurricane is peaceful.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
You sound.
Well, that's probably because they call it the eye of the storm. It's peaceful.
Yeah, but would you be able to keep up with the eye?
Probably not, no.
As soon as it drifts off, like
I really want to go tornado chasing.
Yeah, I don't.
You don't?
No.
I'd love that. Imagine how cool it would just be to see it.
It'd be There was some in Creamfields.
Oh?
Did you see the videos? At Creamfields, there was like tornadoes in the sky.
Fucking hell, that's mad.
Not mental. Like tornado. Not like hurricane tornado.
Did you see...
Okay. Hmm? Nah, come on. Did you see... What, you're shocking, man. Did you see what?
I don't know.
Oh, my Lord. Okay, so you're saying earthquake. I think I'd be able to survive all of them, to be honest. Tsunami. I'll just do what Tom Holland did.
What, just jump in a pool?
Yeah, I'd be sound.
He did survive. Only just, though.
Yeah.
Only just.
He might as well have not have came out very PTSD.
Yeah, to be fair.
You would.
Great fair. Film, though.
That was a great film. What was it called?
The Impossible.
The Impossible. Oh, yeah.
Great film. I'd love to experience a tsunami, though.
And have the...
If I could, guarantee I wasn't going to die, seeing one, how big it'd be. It'd be ridiculous. So I'm not going to earthquake, just experiencing the ground shake. It'd be quite cool.
Yeah. Would it not shoot you up a bit?
No, not really.
Middle of the night, you just wake up and everything's wobbling.
Not really, no. I think it'd be all right.
I think we did experience one in our lifetime, but when we was really young.
Yeah, there was one here when we were very little.
It was Dudley, wasn't it?
Yeah, but because we're in the middle of a tectonic plate, we're not really going to...
We're sound.
We're all right.
Ah.
Same like tsunamis. It'd have to be a massive, massive earthquake, by America, and even then it just go...
Well, tsunamis aren't ever that big, really, are they?
They are.
They're not that big. People imagine tsunamis as bigger than the Empire State. They're nowhere near that big.
I think they can be.
Sorry.
I'll have a search.
The biggest one was based off that film, wasn't it? The Impossible.
The Indonesia one.
That was obviously massive. But that's not Empire State Building massive.
How big are tsunamis?
It'd be interesting to see because I can't remember who it was who told me. They said tsunamis are a lot smaller than everyone thinks. You said that the tectonic plates would have to shift massively for a tsunami.
Oh, no more than 100 feet above sea level.
There you go.
A notable exception was the 1958 tsunami triggered by a landslide in a narrow bay on Alaska's coast. It was over 1,700 feet.
1,700? Now, what's the Empire State Building in feet? 1,700. I'm trying to think how big that is. How many Charlies is that?
Too many. Oh, 1,400 that is.
The Empire State?
Yeah.
So it would have cleared the Empire State?
Yeah, should we look how many Charlies it is?
Jesus Christ. Yeah, how many Charlies would have to beat this tsunami?
293.1.
Stacked upon each other and it still clears you, still decks you.
Yeah.
Oh, you'd be fuming if you was the top Charlie.
Oh, you would. No, you'd be better if anything.
Yeah, what would you do? Dive over?
I'll just dive over it. That's what they're going to do.
All the other Charlies are fucked. They're all just getting swept, and then the top one's just...
Tom Daly,
that'd be one hell of a dive. Mm. But then you get cleared by the second tsunami anyway.
Yeah, and it drags you back in.
Oh, yeah. You'd be screwed.
You would be screwed. But you would have beaten all the other Charlies, so...
Yeah.
It's okay.
There you go. British biscuits. Are you a fan of British biscuits?
Oh, yeah. I love a biscuit.
Yeah.
A bicky.
With a cup of tea.
Oh, yeah.
Do you dunk? Are you a dunker?
I'm a dunker.
Yes. Are you not a dunker? Depends on the biscuit.
Yeah. True. What?
If it's plain digestive, I'll dunk it. Because it's shit flavour anyway.
Not shit flavour,
but... Not shit flavour, but... It's a very dunkable biscuit.
It is, yeah.
And chocolate digestive.
Well, I wouldn't dunk an Oreo in a cup of tea.
No. I'd dunk it milk.
Yeah.
Do you have milk by itself?
Mm.
Yeah, same.
Milk.
What? Milk. What about...
La leche.
Would you dunk a custard cream in tea?
Tea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Probably. Fair enough. We're going to be ranking British biscuits. We've got 14 notorious...
Notorious. British... Conor McGregor biscuits.
Conor McGregor biscuits. Our tier system... Today,
yeah,
because we've got so many, we're gonna do five. We've got get in my belly as a top one, and then we've got yes, just yes, And then, actually, you do the rest, because you normally do the tier list.
No, I'm not with it today, Max.
I know you're not. I can feel it.
I do apologise.
We do move. Charlie's been very busy, busy boy today, but we're going to carry it for him.
I mean, it's all right.
It's all right. We're bringing it back.
And yeah, no thank you.
Yeah, no thanks.
And can smell it from here. That shit fucking reeks.
I didn't actually put that shit fucking reeks.
Nah, but we'll add it in.
Okay.
Needed a bit more spoilers. That was just a bit dead. That was
What, I can smell it from here?
Yeah, I'm chatting shit. So, start off, number one, chocolate bourbons.
Solid. Solid, solid, solid. That is up there. What? Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
Oh, dear. What's going on already? No?
Oh, it's all right.
No, obviously, I would have put it in yes, just yes.
I've never really been a massive fan.
Do you not split them open and then scrape your teeth on the chocolate bit? And then eat the other two sides?
No, I don't, Max.
Well, this is where he's going wrong. Most people understand that.
Sure.
Fine. I'll take it.
No, I'll be able to put in yes, just yes. Because I do enjoy them.
Number two.
Chocolate digestives.
Wow. What are you feeling on this?
Yes, just yes.
Yes, just yes. Yeah. Yeah.
There's not really
no
much to them.
I mean, it's all right. I would probably put them in.
No, I do enjoy.
Okay.
A chocky dive. Chocky dive.
You can't go wrong with chocolate, I suppose.
Number three, the goat. Chocolate fingers.
This is getting my bowler. Oh,
yeah, I love them so much.
Oh,
they yeah. are my honestly, they're my favourite things.
It's the perfect texture of chocolate and crunch.
Yes.
Yes. What's happened? Fuck's sake.
What?
Thingies. Oh, Christ.
Thingies. Number four, we don't discriminate. White chocolate fingers.
See, I was speaking to Charlie about this. You've only had them once, haven't you?
I don't think they do them anymore.
Oh, I hope they still do, because I used to have them all the time. I used to have that with orange Fanta for some reason. I used to have white chocolate with orange Fanta. That combo is insane. Honestly, you need to try that.
Fuck.
Every day I used to have that.
The more I talk to you, the weirder you are.
No, but it was great.
You're always so... I don't know what it is.
I used to go to the co-op every day. I used to look forward to it after White Wickets. Yeah, that's a part down at our place. Go to the co-op, get some white chocolate and a can of orange Fanta and just neck it.
But you're not fat.
Do I look fat? Okay, we said fucking leather weight. Leatherweight, featherweight.
Just a leatherweight. Croggy.
But that, I would love to make a new tier for that, because that is, white chocolate is insane.
Oh, we're making a new tier for it?
No, we won't make a new tier, but it is.
Top end of getting my
belly. Top end of getting my belly.
Okay. Number five, custard creams.
This is a hit and miss relationship for me. Don't know about you. Custard cream.
No, it's just okay.
Yeah, I don't know about you. I started off disliking them, but now I've come to love them.
Oh, I love custard cream. I think they're better than bourbons.
But I think they're yes, just yes.
Oh, yeah, go on. I'm not against that. They're not on chocolate for chocolate fingers.
Some of the bangers are all at the start for some reason.
Yeah, we're gonna get some stinky ones, man.
Same again, same tactic with the custard creams. You got to split it open.
I used to, scrape it all off?
Scrape it with your teeth, the two front teeth, scrape it all down the white chocolate bit in the middle.
So what I used to do, you know, a little like diamond in the middle. Just trying to eat like that, so you had literally just a diamond. That was weird. I also used to put ham on my face as well.
What?
I don't know.
Just put ham on your face?
Yeah.
How did you get from custard creams to
I don't know, I just thought about it. I used to like eat like an eye hole and a mouth hole and just put it on my face. Did you do that as well?
Why did everyone do that?
That was so weird.
Slap it on your face. That is very weird,
like,
isn't it?
It's just unlocked a memory for me, I don't know why. That with Carry On Camping as well, the film, I don't know why. It's just unlocked a thing with me, a memory, I don't know.
British people do weird things.
I don't know, yeah. Fucking hell.
There's some like fridge food like that, like ham. You just fuck on your face. And like, do you ever used to just drink out the OJ bottle as well?
What, the
out,
carton?
Straight out of the carton in the fridge. Squirty cream, I think most people do that.
Yeah,
just,
yeah.
Just random stuff, innit?
Strange people, man. We really are. Number six, hobnob.
No. What's the worst one I can smell it from here? Hobnobs stink.
Yep, I agree. I hate them.
They all...
I hate it.
I hate it. The texture of them, can't even explain. Shit.
It's just like eating gravel.
Yeah.
If you put it in a compact form and dunked it in tea.
Do you know what it reminds me of?
What?
This is quite sad. You know Minecraft when you eat something?
Yeah, it does. That was quite a good impression. Do it again. No, you need to do it a little bit longer.
Why?
That's the noise. It eats a little bit longer. No.
Or longer as in what?
Like quicker, but longer. Hey. Not that long. It's like, do it again.
No, I can't do it now.
That for like 5 minutes.
I'm gonna be like a cocaine addict with no middle thing, whatever it's called. Septum, that's the one.
Next one. Septum. Jammy Dodgers. I mean, it's all right.
What's the one below that?
Yeah, no, thank you.
Yeah, no, thank you. Really? I have to be in a really specific mood to like Jammy Dodgers.
Yeah, to be fair, I agree.
It's just why are you trying to mix health with not health? It's the same vibe as going into McDonald's and asking for a salad.
True.
A fruit bag. Get out. Jamie Vardy. Jamie Vardy.
Malted milk. A really underrated one, in my opinion. That with a cup of tea.
No, no, that without a cup of tea, it could be one of the worst. It's just nothing. Be honest. With a cup of tea, it's banging.
I would say yes, yes, yes.
Should we go? I mean, it's all right. Meet each other in the middle, because I'd be tempted to put that in.
Fine, Max.
Fine, fucking fine.
Fine.
I'm thinking without a cup of tea, because you can't...
Yeah, true.
You can't be having it.
The next one's shit.
Go on.
I don't know how you're going to feel about me saying it, shit. Party rings.
You have not just said that shit. That's my favourite one.
Party rings, your favourite
one. That's my favourite one on the entire.
I think they're shit. They're too hard. They're just... I don't know, man. They're not a biscuit.
Well, that's just changed our whole friendship, actually. I've just realised. I don't feel comfortable around him anymore. I feel like a stranger's just entered my home.
I basically am.
Well, no, not really. It's coming up to a year.
Oh!
Something else is coming up to a year, but we won't speak about that.
Yeah, we won't go into that.
One of my favourites. It gives me nostalgia for some reason. Do you not?
Yeah, it
you used
does,
to have
but...
party rings and juice in primary school.
Mm.
Yeah. So where did it all go wrong for you?
When my dad left home.
He didn't leave home.
We'll cut that out.
No, we'll keep it in. I meant in the party ring realm.
Party? Cool, that sounds. party ring? What the fuck is this episode, man?
God.
I would... What do you mean?
You?
What?
Fucking speak? Party rings, you're not a fan.
Party? I'll go, I mean, it's all right.
God, I don't know if I can allow that. How many have we got in the top two?
One, two, three, four, five.
What's... How many's in yes, just yes, two?
No, three.
Can we put this in the top two or...
Fine. Fucking fine.
And then I'll let you have an opinion on one.
But oh no, because the rest of them are shit.
No, but for me, this is a certified top tier.
Fine.
I have to have this. What's your favourite one?
On there?
On the list?
Oh, we'll do it after.
Okay, sorry.
Number 10, pink wafers.
horrific.
They're not great, are they? People love them too much.
I think they're...
It's all right.
It's all...
No. But even then, yeah, no, thank you.
Yeah, no, thank you.
Just a lot of sugar. I feel like you loved them when you were a kid, but since you turned 12, you're like, oh, no.
Yeah. They look aesthetically pleasing, and that's something that should taste amazing.
But they just don't.
They just taste like paper.
Mm. Fun. Plain digestives?
No. Horrendous. Horrendous.
Yeah, no, thank you.
We actually give our dogs plain digestives. That's their treat.
But it helps with digestion. Well, that's what's called digestive.
You learn something new every day, coach.
God.
So what are you feeling? You can't.
Yeah, no, thank you.
Yeah, no, thank you.
Could we have a cup of tea?
Again, it's similar to malted milk. I think a bit below malted milk.
Oh, yeah. Well, it is. It's the tea. Yeah, yeah. That works out
respectable,
well.
Respectable, yeah.
Number 12, arguably one of the best ones on the list. Do you know what it is?
No.
Try and guess.
Best ones on the list? Oreos?
No.
What?
Shortbread.
Okay.
No. What the fuck? You don't like shortbread?
I used to have, when I was a kid,
yeah,
shortbread tins.
Yeah, so, yeah.
Just like full to the brim.
Yeah.
Because I was obsessed with shortbread.
Mm-hmm.
And then suddenly I realised, don't like shortbread. So that's that.
Great story, Max. Thanks for telling me that.
Maturing is realising shortbread shit.
Maturing is realising your shit.
Maturing is realising no.
All I'm saying, get in my belly. And he said I can have one, so I'm putting it in there. I'm taking control. Not scared.
You're going to use your wild card on this?
Well, yeah, because the other ones are shit. The two left.
Oreos are not shit. Can't believe that. Shortbread. It's just fucking sugar.
Exactly. Number 13, Viennese Wells.
They're class. No? No?
I mean, it's all right.
Fine. I've lost hope at this point.
No. Yes, just yes.
No, put it in, it's all right. It depends what day I'm on, to be fair. And I've already made the comment that why mix healthy stuff?
Yeah, so you can't make yourself look stupid.
Yeah.
Number 14.
The last but not least, definitely not least.
Oreos.
It's got to be up there for me.
Yeah. Yes, just yes.
Yeah.
Not get my belly, but yes, just yes.
Yeah. Same again, though. Anything with, like, stuff
it's
in the middle.
It's got to be paired or something.
No, stuff with the middle, I have to split open and claw at it.
Yeah,
it
wasn't... Oh, what was, like, the marketing scheme they did for that? It was, like, dunk it, twist it, lick it.
Yes, I think it was. Tell you what.
Memory.
That's a good ad, that is, because that's left a...
Yeah, great ad.
Great ad.
Okay, I'm like a nerd out on that.
I've just realised there's actually... UK biscuits are goated, aren't they?
I don't think Oreo is UK.
Oh, is it not? Is it America?
Viennese Wells definitely aren't UK.
No, but...
Because they're from Vienna, so they're Austrian. And also shortbread is Scottish.
I meant biscuits that we eat in the UK.
Oh, well, there's loads more that we eat in the UK. One, you left a goat off here, actually.
What?
The malted milks with chocolate on. They're fucking quality, though. What? You know, the milk
What, with
ones.
A chocolate layer on the top?
Yeah.
I might have.
The milk ones.
They didn't leave an impression if I
Oh,
have.
They are. They're my favourite ones. They're brilliant.
Really?
Yeah, they're so good.
I need to do some research if white chocolate fingers are still about.
You do?
So I might pair that with a can of Fanta and relive those
we'll
days.
Give it you on the next podcast. You can
Yes, have it
involved.
By my size.
Yeah, yeah.
So back to the question I said earlier. What's your favourite on the list? Or favourite in general? Biscuit?
No, we'll go on the list.
On the list.
Yeah. Okay. Chocolate fingers.
Wow! Charlie's favourite biscuit is chocolate fingers.
That silence went on for too long.
I thought I'd make, you know...
What's your favourite biscuit, Max?
I would actually have to say... Mine is white chocolate fingers.
Wow, diversity.
Oof.
Yeah, we can't put that in.
No, but we are.
No, those, no, we're fucking not putting that in.
Have you seen those TikToks when they try and cringe themselves out?
Yeah.
We should do
love
that.
That. They're brilliant.
I can't watch them. Though. I literally can't watch them. Okay. I have to turn the volume to the almost bottom and just be like watching it like that. It's horrific.
Should we try and do it really quickly?
Go on, have a go.
Oh, no, I can't.
No, go on,
Oh, no, I really can't. Can you start? And then I'll ease into it. Okay. No, no, I'm really bad with cringe. I'm really, really bad with cringe.
I'm a Fortnite.
Oh, no, that's horrific. I don't want to do this anymore. No, 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 I actually don't want to do it. No, no, cringe is just disgusting.
Also creamy.
Oh, no, no, it's horrific.
My mama said, hi, how are you?
This is worse than a pantomime, this is.
Anyway, to overview the tier list, we'll go from bottom to top for a change.
Let's do it.
Can smell it from here. Hobby, Hobnobs, Cam Hobby, your bottom tier as well. Joking, obviously.
Drive-by.
Yeah, no thank you. Jammy Vardy, Jammy Dodgers, Pink Wafers and Digestives.
Solid.
I mean, it's all right. Malted Milk and Viennese Whirls. Yes, just yes. Bourbon, Chocolate Digestive, Custard Creams and Oreos. And the goats, get in my belly. We got chocolate fingers, white chocolate fingers, party rings, and shortbread. W.
Good list.
Goated list.
Well done.
Rings clinked then.
Did. We're making good time.
Yeah, boy.
Our mini game.
Oh, so creamy.
Oh, no, let's stop this, please.
Our
party game, mini game of the week.
Ooh.
SpongeBob.
I'm SpongeBob.
Oh. I'm going to play
Sorry, I should have.
Movie.
Wait, what? No, go.
So all of a sudden, Charlie has kicked in only probably 40 minutes into the podcast.
Oh, yeah, I've got energy now.
He's got energy now, somehow. Right, we're going to do a movie theme soundtrack test on Charles, so he hasn't listened to these yet. Some of them are very easy, some of them not so easy, and I don't even know if you've seen the film, but sure. Yeah.
Well, we'll give it a go.
We'll give it a go. I'll play it down the mic. Hopefully you guys can hear it fine and it's not here.
Sam on Xbox, play it down the mic.
Are you ready for the first one?
Oh, yes.
Very easy. Join in at home. You have 15 seconds to answer.
Harry Potter.
Which one?
Oh, the first one. Philosopher's Stone. Is it? Is that actually?
Yeah. Well, it's all of them, really, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. But that one.
Okay, number two.
Jaws.
Yeah.
I couldn't hear it. I just heard it.
Do you want me to turn it up? And then... Got 5 seconds. You're locked in with Jaws.
I am.
It was Jaws, but hey.
It's actually a shit film.
Yeah, I don't like it.
It's a really easy one. Did you know it?
Transformers.
Oh, I would not have got that.
Next one, number four.
Mission Impossible.
Yes. Well, no. Sorry, 10 seconds. Do you want to lock it in? Was Mission Impossible.
Wow. Tommy Boy.
Next one. Number five.
Oh.
There's no way you know this.
I recognise it. Indiana Jones. No?
1 second.
Titanic.
The Godfather.
Oh, of course it is.
Number six. I knew this one.
Avatar?
I should just show you this, by the way.
Is it Avatar? Yeah!
Avatar, yay! Number seven.
How many are there?
We'll do three more. Not clue? You don't know this. Just not.
It's all funny. I don't know. Is it? Oh, I only got that. Oh, that's another film.
You don't know.
Travis Fire. Is that Travis Fire? Is it?
You've locked in what?
I don't know, mate. Yeah, I wouldn't have got that. I know the song, but not Apocalypse Now. I'm doing terrible, man. What the fuck is this?
If you don't know number 10, by the way, you're shit. You don't know this?
Not a clue. No? Am I being stupid?
Gladiator. You have watched it?
Yeah, but I don't remember the songs.
You should know this. You don't know it.
That's the future.
Oh, I thought say. I thought you weren't going to get it. Right.
Try and out me like that.
Trying to do some more? Or...
Oh, yeah, I'm enjoying this.
Okay.
My favourite film. Quality.
Well, actually, I don't know these, by the way. I'm going to say Ratatouille.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Ratatouille.
I don't know them from there on out. Ratatouille.
Oh, of course it is. Fuck's sake.
I knew it was a Disney film.
Yeah. I'm enjoying these.
Number 12.
Oh.
That's Indiana Jones, isn't it?
Sounds like it.
That is, yeah. I hope in the audio.
Or is it Star Wars? No, I mean it's Indiana Jones.
Indiana
I think it
Jones.
Is, yeah.
Nice. Superman? The movie?
Oh, my sake.
What?
You're doing terrible. Indiana Jones.
That's not Indiana Jones.
I'm chatting shit.
Oh, what is that from? What's that from? I can't think. All right.
What the fuck is that?
I've got a Requiem for a Dream.
Requiem? I have no idea.
Not a clue, not a clue. It sounds familiar. I feel like I'm going to kick myself. The Dark Knight. Harry would have known that, I think. Fuck. This is Marvel, isn't it?
Yeah.
Avengers. Or just Marvel in general. Is it?
I think so. Yeah, I think it is. Maybe Avengers. Or Iron Man, maybe.
Avengers, assemble.
Yeah. Wow.
Right, we'll do a few more. Four more. I was going to say Indiana Jones again. They all sound Indiana Jonesy.
Oh, Star Wars.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Could be Star Wars. Jurassic Park.
For fuck's sake.
Shocking.
Indiana Jones.
No, not close.
It sounds like noise to me.
That sounds like the last one, Jurassic Park, yeah. Again. E.T.
What are they all sound the same?
I haven't seen that in like 2,000 years.
Nice.
Ghostbusters. Yeah. I would not have got it before that.
No.
Goated song.
Oh, Matrix.
No. What's he called? Freddy...
Krueger.
Freddy Krueger. No, not Freddy Krueger. The other one.
Halloween.
Halloween.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Halloween.
Mike Myers. Sure.
Mike Myers. Yeah. Yes!
Well done.
Last one.
Butlers. Titanic.
The Lion King.
Wow.
Wow, that's a good one to end on, I suppose.
We did really well there.
Yeah, we didn't. Did we really?
No, we did terrible.
So, I think I've seen all of them except from that Requiem is a Dream. Yeah. And
Requiem the Dream.
Requiem is a Dream and The Godfather. I've never seen The Godfather.
Have you not?
No.
Great film.
Is it?
Long, though.
Is it very long? One of those.
Very long, but very good.
Well, that was everything.
Yeah.
That was everything. Short but sweet podcast. Charlie is going to die after this, go to sleep, hopefully, for his sake.
Hopefully on Friday, I'm more up for it.
Yeah, we're going to be shooting in 3 days' time, so should be good. Should be good by then. But thanks for tuning in. As always, if you made it this far, we love you. Give us a 5-star rating on Spotify, please.
Please.
And don't be afraid to drop a comment of what you want to see, what type of content you want to see.
Yeah, and how much you hate me and Max as well.
Also that as well. And if you found the cringy part very cringy, because I did.
Oh, don't leave that in.
I will.
For fuck's sake.
Okay, first word that comes to mind, Charles?
Bed.
Tired.
Nice.
That sums up the entire episode. This has been episode 9 of the Good Day Podcast. Approaching 10. Going to be in that top 5%. Got a corker coming on next week, so stay tuned. Thank you, Charles, for not dying.
It's all right.
Anything else you'd like to add?
I'm going to get to bed.
He wants to go to bed, so we're going to end it here, folks. Thank you.
Goodbye. Bye. Love you.